us in every life. We are praying for a manifestation of the assignment of God being brought forth even in the life of each one, in the mighty name of Jesus, that men and women begin to fulfill the calling of God in their lives, that men and women begin to fulfill all that God has said concerning them. Lord, we release this service into your hand. We release this service into your hand for signs, for wonders, for miracles, for opening of the eyes in the name of Jesus. We release this service into the hand of the Holy Spirit, that there will be signs and wonders here. There will be a time that people get to know the true and live living God. Lord, we pray for those online this morning, even as the word will come to them, that the word will bring about a change and a turnaround. The Bible says he sent forth his word, and his word healed them and delivered them of all their destruction. So we pray this morning that even as the word will go forth, it will go and deliver, it will go and save, it will go and transform lives. That as the word will go, men will be healed. As the word goes, men will be instructed. As the word goes, men will be comforted. As the word goes, men will be delivered. As the word goes, people will receive salvation. Father, we give you praise this morning because we trust you. Hallelujah. Bible says where two or more shall touch and agree concerning anything upon even your word, the Bible says is established. So Lord, we give you praise this morning as we lift up our hands. People of God, lift up your hand. Are you expecting something today? Lift up your hands. Hallelujah. Give him the glory. Give him the praise. Father, we worship you. Father, we give you glory. Father, we give you honor. We are expectant. We are expectant. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let's let our praise resound louder than anything else. We just thank you, Lord, that we get to praise your name. We get to give you honor. We get to give you glory. We get to minister back to you with our praise. Hallelujah.
You are God, and we lift you up. We keep singing. We keep praising. We won't stop giving all we got, 'cause you're worthy of all glory. Oh, there is no other. You are forever, Lord, over all. There's nobody like you, no one beside you.
That's why we sing it out to you.
To you. Let endless praise resound every night and day, and with no delay. Let endless praise resound to you.
Hallelujah! We're gonna let our endless praise resound to you, God. You're worthy of it all. Oh, you're so worthy of it. Thank you, Lord.
Before the sun, your glory eternal never stops. Giving all you got, creation keeps singing. Oh, there is no other. You are forever, Lord, over all. There's nobody like you, no one beside you.
glory to your name, God. Hallelujah. All right, now we're gonna keep it going. We're gonna continue to stir ourselves up this morning. What an honor, what a privilege it is to worship the Lord. Woo! I don't need a reason this morning. Amen. We don't need a reason. Sing on. Oh, oh, oh.
Declare and lift you high. choose to believe every word that you've spoken. Every word that you said about me, I believe it, God. I believe your word, your word.
Lift our hands this morning. Come on, let's lift up our hands to the one that we trust, the one that will never fail you. Come on, the one who will never leave you, the one that will never forsake you. Come on, let's just lift our hands up. Let's honor him this morning. We thank you right now, Father, that you're a good God. You're a good Father. You will never fail us. You will never leave us. You will never forsake us. Come on. And we put our trust into you. Come on. We believe the word of the Lord that we will not lean to our own understanding, but we will trust in you. Confidence, faith, trust in you, Lord. We trust you, God. We trust you. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, good morning to you. Come on, with a smile on your face this morning on this hot summer day, good morning to you. Well, if I had not had the opportunity to meet you, my name is Minister Ty. I want you to turn to two or three people here in the sanctuary, and if you're online, go ahead and chat that in. Say, I trust God. Come on, God is faithful.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yikro stava digo, vayekon diriesho, faleliki mama. Faleleki broshulakadai, rekidufa ashereke, brusto vashia gandodo. Mayuko duviste gendo, vrofom bumai, akandu vitu, esh engongo, brefe shikandaranda.
I am God. I am He. I am the author and the finisher of your faith. I said in my word that you can trust me. Trust me with everything. Trust me with everything. Trust me with everything, says the Spirit of the Lord.
Bikro falai bolinko mantaiko brosuke brestu gabama lerontu. Mi cuore sequero brostum baiaratu, chi custero bro valandere kibru frostica brama acoria peesce ama akete.
I am the author and the finisher of your faith. What does that mean? I am Alpha and Omega. I am the beginning and the end. I will never fail you. I will never forsake you. All I'm asking you to do is to trust me. Trust me. Trust me, trust me.
Enu Cristo, akradati ke rosh aimo o bayala ke dombisto brasta inkandaya Cristungaya eka a us ekera.
If I did it before, I'll do it again. If I did it before, I'll do it again. I am the healer. I will heal every situation that you're dealing with. The word of God says, I am the healer. All you you have to do is trust in me, put your faith in me, and so says the Spirit of grace. Hallelujah. Let's lift up our hands this morning. Let's just honor God. He is the author and the finisher of our faith. Let's just honor him this morning. Let's get excited about who he is. He is a trustworthy. He is faithful. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. He will never fail you. He says, put your trust in him, says the Spirit of grace. Come on, let's lift up our hands. Let's just honor him and get excited about who he is in Jesus' name. Well, what you heard was tongues and interpretation of tongues found in 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and chapter 14. Were you edified? Were you comforted? Were you encouraged that God is faithful to finish what he started? In Jesus' name, we love you, Lord. We honor you this morning. We thank you, Lord. We set a posture of honor and trust in you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. What a great time where we could just kind of just be in God's presence, right? Be led by the Holy Spirit in everything that we do because he is faithful. Turn to your neighbor and say, he is faithful. Yes, he is. So we can go ahead and run the announcements at this time.
Well, hey there, everyone. My name is Beatrice. Welcome to Faith for Life. We are glad you're joining us today. Either online or here in the sanctuary, we want to say welcome. Just when everyone thinks the story is over, Jesus steps in and changes everything. We believe church is important, more than a place to show up every Sunday. Church is you and me. Connect with us at Faith for Life. So grab the card on the seat back in front of you that says connection card. Take a few seconds to fill out a little bit of information about you, or if you have a prayer request, write it on the back of the connection card. Once completed, place the card in the gold box in the lobby, or if you're online, click the button that says start here, and that's it. Have you registered for the School of the Bible? These classes are strategically designed to cover the foundational parts of growing in your faith, the basics of believing Christianity, tips and tools for reading and studying the Bible, and practical ways to share what you believe with others. Classes start Thursday, September 7th, 2023, and space is limited. Go to our website, www.faithforlifeaus.com, to register. Here at Faith for Life, one of the things we're most passionate about is reaching the next generation. When a child grows up knowing that they are loved by God and created by him for a purpose, it doesn't just change their life, but it can impact an entire family. God is doing some amazing things in the lives of our kids here at Faith for Life Church. For example, we have Kids World. Sunday Summer Blast is ongoing through the month of July with biblical teachings, high energy worship, outside activities, and more. The Ignite Student Ministry Friday Night Live Game Night is on Friday, July 14th at 7 p.m. If your kids or teenagers have never been to one of our services before, we'd love to have you and your family stop by and check one out. Go to the website www.faithforlifeaus.com to find out more information. At Faith for Life Church, we do more than just open our doors on Sundays. We want to walk with you through difficult times. As a reminder, Faith for Life provides pastoral cares in the areas of marriage, family relationships, premarital education, one-on-one mentoring, divorce recovery, addictive behavior recovery, and grief support, and more. This is free to all members. We also want to support and pray with you as you experience any type of life-transforming circumstance. To let us know how we can help, go to our website at www.faithforlifeaus.com, click the About header, then Pastoral Care. Thanks so much for being here with us today. We believe you're here for a reason. God has something he wants to say specifically to you wherever you're at. Our hope is that you today leave encouraged and closer to him than ever before. Let us know if we can help in any way to be sure to connect with us on our website or on social media to stay up to date with everything happening here. Have a great weekend.
Good morning, Faith for Life. How are y'all doing today? Come on, is everything good? Yeah. Come on, did he keep you? Yeah. Come on, did he raise you? Yeah. Come on, are you well? Yeah. Come on, is God good? Yeah. Come on, let's just lift our hands to him and tell him, thank you, Lord, for being so good to us. Oh, Father, we thank you for being so good to us. so good to us all the days of our life. Well, I have an opportunity to share with you that today is offering time. I mean, right now is offering time. Amen? Praise God. I know we've been worshiping through praise and worship, and, you know, we've had God come in and speak unto our heart by His Spirit of grace, but we get to do more. Come on, we get to do more. Come on, we get to do something for Him. We get to minister back unto Him in another way, and that's through tithes and offerings. So I just want to share with you, there is three ways that you can give here at Faith for Life. One of the ways that you can give, if in the seat pocket in front of you, there is an envelope where you can simply fill it out in its entirety. And then at the end of the service, there is a gold box in the lobby on the right-hand side when you go out, left-hand side when you go out, and you can put it in there. Another way that you can give is you can simply go online, and there's a spot that says giving. If you just simply follow those directions, you can give that way. But then there's another way. Say smart giving. Smart giving is a simple way, a way you can simply text in a number for your very first time. You fill out that form and you never have to fill it out again. You can just simply text any giving amount to that. So I just ask right now that you check your heart and see what God will have for you to do. And as you do that, I'm going to share with you something from Ecclesiastes chapter 11. Amen. So Ecclesiastes chapter 11 and verse 1, it says this: cast thy bread upon the waters, for thou shalt find it after many days. Give a portion to seven and also to eight. For thou knowest not what evil shall be upon the earth. If the clouds be full of rain, they empty themselves upon the earth. And if the tree falleth to the south or towards the north, in the place where the tree falleth, there it shall be. He that observeth the winds shall not sow. He that regardeth the clouds shall not reap. As you thou knowest not the way in which the Spirit is, in which the Spirit is, nor how the bones grow in the womb of the her that was child. Even so thou knowest not the work of God who maketh all. Verse 6. In the morning sow thy seed. In the evening withhold not thy hand. For thou knowest not whether thou shalt prosper on the right hand or the left hand, or they both shall be good. Come on, I got the opportunity to share with you that it is seed sowing time. Praise God. Glory to God. Amen. It's seed sowing time. Well, the reason that we get excited about seed sowing time is because one of the things that the Lord shared with us in Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. Anybody remember what it talks about? It says, seed time and harvest shall not cease. So as long as there is a sun, as long as there is cold and heat, as long as there is day and night, as long as there is summer and winter, this system of seed time and harvest will not stop. Amen? Praise God. Well, I believe that you had an opportunity to do what it is that you're going to do. And I just want to share one other thing specifically about this. It says this. It says that you don't know the ways of the Spirit, but our responsibility is just so. He says, because what's going to happen if you sow, all of a sudden, after many days, it's going to come rolling back in. Come on, glory to God. It's going to come rolling back in, and God is faithful to do exactly what He promised. Amen? Come on, isn't that what He said in that Thompson interpretation? Come on, amen. Well, praise God. I believe you've done what you're going to do. Whether you have your iPad, an envelope, or you've given online, just come on and stand up with me. And what we're going to do is we're going to decree our tithers confession, right? We're going to sow our seed. Amen? Praise God. So simply, I'm going to say it first and just simply repeat this after me. Say, because we are tithers, the windows of heaven are open and the blessing is pouring out. Because we are sowers, we are furnished in abundance for every good work. We receive our jobs, perfect assignments, raises and bonuses, contracts, benefits, sales, and commissions. Settlements, estates, and inheritances, interest and income, rebates and returns, and checks in the mail. Come on, supernatural wealth transfer. Come on, scholarships, tuitions paid in full, bills paid off, and debts demolished.
Supernatural wealth transfer, scholarships, tuitions paid in full, bills paid off.
Royalties received and properties required. Come on, let's put some action to that. Come on. Say royalties received and properties acquired. What's a royalty? A royalty is when you do something and then from what you've done for the rest of your life, you get paid off of it. Can you take some of that? Say, royalties received and properties acquired. We are getting our buildings, our lands, our houses, our vehicles, our equipment, and our aircrafts. Notice how it's coming. God is bringing into our hands seed.
God is bringing into our hands seed.
We command abundant harvest to come.
We command
harvest angels.
Let me
go back to that. I skipped that. Let's go back over that. Say,
abundant harvest.
Come to us now.
Harvest angels.
Go get it.
Bring it to us.
Right now,
in Jesus' name.
In whose name?
In Jesus'
name. The one who has all authority and power. Come on, let's give him glory and honor. Father, we thank you that the angels are hearkening to the voice of your word. We thank you that they're doing it just so. Father, you said that we shall decree a thing and it shall be established. So we thank you that it is done and so in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. Praise God. Anybody excited about it? Come on, anybody expecting? No. I mean, are you really, truly expecting? Come on, glory to God. Well, amen. Well, we're going to get right over into the word. So I want you to make this declaration of faith with me. Say, Father God,
your word
is spirit
and life
and truth.
And every time
I read,
I meditate,
I declare
the word of God,
supernatural things take place. No, I don't think you heard what I said. Supernatural things take place. So my eyes, I open to see what you want to show me. My ears, I open to hear what the Spirit of grace is saying. So come on, let's stretch our hands wide open. Okay, the reason why we do this, we're saying, Father God, in this moment, our heart is, this is the posture of our heart, ready to receive from you. And say, Father,
my heart
is wide open
to receive from you
a word of direction,
a word of correction,
a word of instruction
to receive your incorruptible seed
planted in my heart
by faith,
and it shall
bring forth a harvest,
some 30-fold,
some 60-fold,
and some 100-fold.
Now, if you believe that, give God glory and honor and praise.
So, Father, we thank you that it is so in Jesus' name. We trust you. We agree with it even before we see it because we know it's coming for you and we know that you're looking to do us good all the days of our lives. Now, Father God, I ask that your grace will rest upon me, that I make known the very manifold wisdom of God. I say, Father God, that I shall not speak with enticing words of man's wisdom, but it shall be in demonstration and power of the Holy Ghost. I say, Holy Spirit, have your way. My tongue is connected to my spirit, which is connected unto you. Whatever you decide to say, whatever you decide to do, we say, feel free, have freedom. Take your liberty in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Well, just say hello to your neighbor to the left or right, and then you can go ahead and be seated. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Glory to God. Come on, we're a church. We know about hospitality here, right? Come on, we're given the hospitality. We know how to treat others. We know how to love on others. Amen? Well, praise God. Well, today specifically, the Lord has called me to bring up a series that I started actually when I first got here. It was my mandate when I first started. See, there are certain, well, let me say this like this. Let me just say it this way. There is no word that's in the word of God that we've heard enough. Would you agree with that? There's a reason why God wrote this down.
Right? So hearing it one time is not good enough. How many of you know that? You ever heard, somebody ever told you something one time and you forgot about it?
Yeah.
You know? Anybody ever hear something two times and, you know, didn't think about it? Come on, anybody, four or five, come on, you know, come on. There's a reason why, the reason when you train children up, when you bring them up, you do it through what? Repetition, right? Because as soon as they leave your presence, what? They're going to forget about it, right? Matter of fact, scientists say that it takes you to hear something seven times before you get it. Come on, how many, the first time your parents told you your birthday, you remembered it? No, no. It took you some time. And some of us now don't even think about it. Oh, yeah, today is my birthday, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to look at something which is vital, vital to Christianity. There is no way around it. You can't get past it. You have to have this in order to win in life. You have to have it to have life. There is no way to sidestep it. You know that, you know, there may be a time like when you were studying for a test in school, you know, you may have, you know, waited till the last minute and tried to study so that you can get the, you know, get the answers right. And generally what happened? Whatever you did gain by the time that you put your pencil down, you forgot it, right? So our thing is not to forget what we're about to hear. We don't want to be forgetful hearers. That's what the Word of God says. But we want to be doers of the Word of God. Amen? So I want to encourage you, with your phone, with your iPads, with your pens, whatever you have, take notes. Take notes. I'm reiterating, take notes. If you don't have it, go back, listen to it again, and take notes. This series is vital to life and success. Anybody like life? Anybody like successful living? Well, this series will do it. How long are we going to be on it? Till the Lord say we're on it long enough. Do you want to know the title of it? Oh, you don't? Okay, that's all right. I'll go ahead and leave. You want to know the title of it? The title is Faith. 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 Do you know that you never get too big for faith? You know, I remember my grandma when they said, "Don't get too big for your britches." I think that's what she said, right? Well, you never get too big for faith. There is no one who is living on this earth has gotten past the point where they don't need faith, including me, including you, including us, including you too. Yeah, you on stream, I'm talking to you. We all need this. It's so vital to our lives. So what we're going to do is we're going to take faith and we're going to put it under a microscope. You know what? One of the reasons why you look at it, get a microscope, is so you can look down into areas that you can't actually see with your natural eye. All right? You know, they even have little kid microscopes where you can take a leaf and you can put it under there and you can zoom in and see what's going on. Seeing that it's actually there's life flowing through that too. Amen? So that's what we're going to do with faith. We're going to just take it like, let's just say this was faith. And what we're going to do is we're not going to say, oh, this is faith, and just put it down. What we're going to do is look at it. We're going to look at it. We'll go all the way around. Look at the top. Look at the bottom. We're going to observe it, right, in its natural state, in its real state. Well, we're going to find out, well, is it wet? Does it keep the same shape when I pour it out the bottle? Can it come out the bottle? At what point does it change forms? Does it change forms? Right? We're going to take our time. We're not going to be in rush. Because this is, without faith, we can't have life. Without faith, we can't be successful. Without faith, we can't win. Without faith, we can't have anything that's good. Anybody like good things? Amen. Then we're going to need some faith. Amen? So, let's go ahead and start. Amen? Now, we're not going to start how you would normally think that we're going to start. Oh, do this, do this. See, Jesus is the master teacher. How many know that? Jesus knows everything about absolutely everything. Do you know that Jesus knew about cancel culture before cancel culture happened? You know that? Do you know that Jesus knows about what's going to be an invention 10 years from now? He knows everything about it. And guess what? If we would see that through faith that the Lord Jesus is actually setting us up so that when things show up in the earth, that we can take advantage of it for his good, for his kingdom. You know what? He might even use you to bring it from heaven to earth. You know how that's done? Faith. Glory to God. Amen? All right, so let's go over here to Hebrews chapter 10. I'm going to start with verse 35. Glory to God. I want to encourage you to get excited about this. Not excited for me. I'm not asking you to get excited for me. I'm asking you to get excited for yourself. Right? The reason why God is telling us, remember we were talking about, anybody still have their vision list? Anybody know what a vision list is? Okay, so let me just share. For those who may not have been here at the beginning of the year, one of the things that the Lord placed on our hearts to do is to start a vision list. And it's still on our website where you can simply go on online, and what you do is you print out this simple sheet, and the sheet just asks you a couple of questions. The first thing is, what is it that you want to do for God this year? The next thing is, what is it that you are believing God to do for you this year? Right? And find those appropriate scriptures or promises that line up with that, and put your faith on it. See, a lot of times what happens, you know, it's just like the New Year's resolution. What happens? Beginning of the year, you can't get into a gym. You have to make reservations. It's full. You got to wait around for a machine. Oh, man, I want to go on a treadmill. You got to wait because they're all taken up. And somebody's standing in line waiting for somebody to jump off. You don't have to wait much longer. I tell you, like right now, you can walk in any time of day and get you a treadmill. Why? Because most people fail. They don't endure. They give up. Well, that's not a part of faith. Amen? So I want to encourage you, if you have not done that, take this time to go get it, because it's not too late for God to do what he's going to do. God is a God who can redeem the time. Even though you start, jump in right now, plug in right now, God can still have that thing manifest before the end of the year. Amen. Now, just a quick show of hands, just in case someone's like, oh, this guy's nuts. It really don't matter if you think that or not. It just matters what Jesus thinks. But let me ask you this. Who here God has ever told them to believe God for something and then it showed up that same year? Let me see your own hands. So you keep your hands up. So for all those who don't know or don't think it's right, you can just simply look and see. The word of God says in Romans chapter 2, verse 11, he says it says that God is not a respecter of person. So if he did it for all these with their hands showed up, he'll do it for you. However, you must be in faith. Must be in what?
Faith.
All right. So let's go over here to Hebrews chapter. Again, I'm just going to introduce it today. I'm not trying to run through this because it does no good for us to run through something. That's just like if you call someone, like my grandmother, she could make a sweet potato pie so good. It wouldn't do me any good if I got on the phone with her when she was live before she was promoted to heaven and said, grandmother, tell me the ingredients of how to do this. She said, okay, you need to do this and that, do this and this and that, and this and this and this and this. All right, see you later, bye. She gave me all the information, but I didn't have time to take it in. I didn't have time to write it down. I didn't have time to take notes. And as a result, guess what? It's lost, right? The way that she made what she made, that which I enjoyed, is now lost. So we don't want to lose things here. We want to gain, amen? God always wants us to go from faith to faith and glory to glory. In other words, God is a God of increase. Amen. Come on, say that to me. Say, God is a God of increase. Come on, let's make it a little more personal. Say, my Father is a Father of increase. Anybody believe that?
Amen.
All right. Praise Jesus. So here in Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 35, we'll pick it up here. It says, cast not away therefore your confidence, which has great recompense of reward. In other words, it pays off. For you have need of patience, that after you have done the will of God. Now you need to highlight that. Done the will of God. Well, what is the will of God? The will of God is the plan of God. Well, where can we find God's plan? Where is that? All right. So in other words, the Bible is the playbook of the believer. The Bible is the playbook of the believer. You know, one of the things that happen when people are drafted into the NFL, one of the things that they give them when they join the team is that they give them a playbook. And their responsibility is to learn that playbook, to know that playbook. Why? So that at any time they can call any play that is in that book and everyone will know where they're supposed to be, what they're supposed to do. And if everyone's in their right spot, and if everyone does what they're supposed to do, then they will have what? Success. But notice it says, after you have what? Done the will of God. So that means that we're going to have to do something. Faith is not sitting on the couch, reading a couple scriptures, putting your feet up and saying, do it, Lord. That's not faith. But notice it says, after you have done, not your mama, not your brother, not your sister, not your cousin, not your spouse, not anybody else, but after you have personally done the will of God. What about if people told you, I read the word of God, but it didn't do nothing for me? That has nothing to do with you. Because it tells us here that after we have done, completed, or another way to say it, after we have cooperated with God. Now remember, Jesus said in our other series we were talking about, Jesus said, of myself, I can't do nothing. It's the Father that does the work. And we found out how Jesus was able to do many miracles. Well, the way that Jesus was able to do miracles was that he cooperated with God. Remember, Jesus told his disciples, let's go over to the other side. Well, why was he able to say, let's go over to the other side? Remember, Jesus said, I only say what I hear my Father say, and I only do what I see my Father do. So the Father showed him that he was supposed to be on the other side. So he told the disciples, we're going over there. Now, notice this. When things happened, when that word came forth, there was opposition. But the opposition wasn't strong enough to stop him. Why? Because Jesus trusted the Father more than he trusted the opposition. Oh, that's good right there. That's good right there. That's a hot take. That's a hot take right there. Okay. After you have done the will of God, you might receive the promise. So faith will cause you to receive. Now, I'm not just going to give you some words today. Today, I'm going to also give you some testimony. See, a lot of times people think, well, that's the Bible. That's 2,000 years from now, 2,000 years ago. That was good for back then. That was that time. See, the word of God is eternal, meaning that there is not a time that it doesn't work. Not only is there not a time that it does not work, there's not a place where it does not work. One of the things that we had prayer on yesterday, and woo, it was good. I'll tell you, it was good. One of the things that we find out is that the word of God, not only does it work in Austin, not only does it work in Round Rock, but it works in China, it works in Brazil. Not only there, it works on the moon. How you know it works on the moon? How you know it don't? The word of God works everywhere. Amen. Praise God. Again, we slow rolling. Praise the Lord. Verse 37. For yet a little while, and he that shall come will come and shall not tarry. So who is the one that shall come? No. Who is the one that shall come? Jesus, right? Okay. There's going to be a little while, and he's going to come, right? Verse 38. Now the just, that means the innocent, the justified, those who have been declared right, it said, shall they what? They shall what? So that tells us that faith is going to give you life. Well, is there sickness in your body? That's okay. That's all you need. Just need some faith. Because it's going to give you life. I remember this was some years ago. I was looking on television, and this guy was giving a testimony about his name. I don't know. Have anyone ever heard of the evangelist Reinhard Bucke before? Okay. He's a missionary. He would spend a lot of time in Africa. At the end of his years, he spent a lot of time actually in the United States as well. But one of the things that happened was he was doing a message. And some people tried to bring a casket into his meeting. This person was dead, died tragically. If I'm not mistaken, I think he might have been a pastor too. They were like, hold on. Because see, the wife said, if I can just get him in a meeting, he's gonna be raised up. I want you to think about this. For someone, they're supposed to be going to the burial site. They said, no, turn left here. Turn right here. Okay, pull up in there. It's a service going on. Pull up in there. All right, stop. Hey, y'all, get out and get that casket. I want you to see this. They get the casket and they open the doors trying, and somebody say, hold on, hey, what you think you're doing? What you doing? Well, we're going to bring in here because, what's going to happen is my husband's going to get healed up, going to get raised up. So what wound up happening is like, okay, look, lady, you can't bring a dead body in the service. But this is what we'll let you do. If you take him out the casket, we're going to let you take him in the basement. But not in the sanctuary where everybody at. Okay, y'all act like people just walk in with dead bodies all the time. You act like people, oh yeah, somebody just walked in with dead bodies. But you know what? Praise God, we believe God for the time when that will happen. So they go downstairs. And Reinhard Bunker is just, he's preaching. He's declaring the word of God. He is unaware what's going on in the basement. They have him laid out on the table. There's video of this too. So it's just not someone's account. All of a sudden, the man takes in breath. And starts breathing. Now, you know what's going on now. There's a bunch of commotion and records going on now. Down in the basement. In so much that the people from upstairs went to go find out what happened. So then there was an article in the paper of the pastor holding a newspaper article showing his death, and he was holding his death certificate. Raised up from the dead. How many of you know that you can't get prepared for a storm in a storm? That's not the time to prepare for it. The time is to prepare before. So how did that happen? It happened by faith. Now there's a whole bunch that had to happen in order for somebody to be raised from the dead. Now think about this. Whatever killed them got to be fixed. Right? Or if they come back to life, what, they're just going to die again, right? So it got to be fixed. Not only that, you know what happened. All the blood and all that stuff is taken out. Organs and stuff are taken out. So there's a lot of creative miracles and things that have to happen. Faith. There's a gentleman by the name of Smith Wigglesworth. He has several people, it just known of raising people from the dead. Now, did he do it? No. He cooperated with God and God did it. But how? It by faith. Why am I telling you this? Because there are some people who have situations that seem like they are dead. That if you would believe God, you will see his resurrection power. Remember what he told? Remember what he told Martha? She said, I know in that great day, my brother shall be raised. What did Jesus say? He said, I am the resurrection. Glory to God. It all happens by faith. Come on, if he can heal somebody, raise somebody from the dead, what's your finances? Come on, what's sickness in your body? Come on, what's, I've been born on the wrong side of the tracks. What's, I messed up before I met Jesus. What's all that? That doesn't matter. All you need is faith. In God. Can you see why faith is so vital? Do you know that faith can supersede inflation? It can supersede the economy. I mean, supersede, what is that? Okay, so the reasons why airplanes are able to fly, think about a big piece of metal, is because they use the law of lift. So gravity is always working. So if the plane engines and things stop working, it will begin to descend. Why? Because gravity is still working, right? But when you have thrust in a wingspan, what happens? You supersede the law of gravity and you're able to go to new heights. Even though gravity is still working. So that's what God is telling us about faith today. He says, I'm telling you about the law of faith so that you can supersede anything that this world is trying to put on you or bring against you. Oh, man. In other words, where it has no effect on you. Praise Jesus. Well, that's okay. It's good preaching. I'm going to listen to this again myself. Okay. It says, now the just shall live by faith, but if any man draw back, shrink up, turn away, decide to go another way, let it go, abandon it, What did he say? Turn back to this perdition, which is destruction. The just shall live by faith, but if any man turn back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. See, our whole part is this. God loves us, right? And we can't do anything to make God not love us. But we can do those things which are pleasing to him. Right? We always want to please him. Now, verse 39, we pick it up here. But we are not them that draw back, that shrink up, that turn away, that abandon and go to destruction, but them that believe to the saving of our soul. So that tells us something else about faith. It is by faith we are saved. I'm just going to tell you some stuff about faith today. So we found out what? We live by it. We found out that it'll save our soul. We find out that if we do the will of God, then we'll receive the promise. Come on, right? All right, let's go over to verse 11. Come on. Right here. Verse 11 in chapter 1, it says, Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. I'm not going to touch that today. That's a whole lot there. For by it, what is that word it? That word is it refers to faith. For by faith, the elders obtain a good report. This is telling us something else. When we live by faith, when we operate by faith, then we obtain a good report. So that means without faith, we can't obtain a good report. What else is it saying? It says, through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God. So again, it's telling us something again about faith, that it framed things. What that word frame means, it means to order. And that was talking about the worlds. It's actually talking about the different ages, how things change in different ages. It says that things are orchestrated in the changing of ages based on our faith in the word of God. In other words, you can have a country that's looked like it's going to hell in a handbasket. A flaming one on top of that. But if you take the word of God and operate in faith as God says, that nation will turn around and turn to God. That's what it means to be shaped. It means that the family could be going this way. Living a life broke, busted, disgusted, don't know God, and have no hope. But through faith in God's word and doing his will, his plan, he's saying you can turn that thing around. Well, the family is now a family that serves the true and living God. Amen. That's what that frame means. To order, to orchestrate, to make it go a certain way. In other words, the reason that the world is the way that it is that the church let it get that way. Woo! But also, guess what? If we let it get that way, then we can turn it back around the way that it should go, right? Amen? Come on, this is all through faith. See, we should never be the one, oh, man, them Republicans, oh, man, them Democrats, oh, man, them the people in power, oh, man. We shouldn't be doing that. Why? Because we, through God's plan, have the ability to turn everything around. You know when the world is really messed up? When God calls us up out of here. That's when there's a problem. But as long as we're here, those who will believe God and act in faith, oh, this thing can be turned around. Oh, I want you to remember this, though. There is coming a day when there will be a massive harvest of souls. So don't think that it's all over with. There's coming a day where there'll be such a harvest of people accepting Jesus, you're going to be like, whoa, it's going to be more than all those who have been saved before. Oh, okay. Through faith, we understand that the worlds or the ages were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made with things that do appear. By faith, or we can say, when it says by faith, it's saying it through this channel of faith. as working through faith, these how all these things are now coming to pass. So what we're about to read now are things that if we would stand in faith, we would have the manifestation as well. You ready? All right, so let's go look and highlight some things. Okay. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gift, and by him being yet dead, yet speaking. So what? When we give in faith, guess what? We're giving a more excellent sacrifice. So when we do tithes and offering, there's a reason why we made this tighter confession. Because what we're doing is we're releasing our faith. We're not just throwing money in a bucket. How many know throwing money in a bucket, texting money, putting money in a box is not going to make stuff happen for you? Right? Because if that's to say, that means that if you went outside of your trash can and you threw a quarter in there, that means you're going to be blessed, right? No, but it's about when you declare something by faith, giving it unto him, sanctifying or separating it for him and his purpose and his plan, then he says, I'm going to bless that. Not only that, but remember it says he testified of it. So God said, oh, that's good. Oh, okay, that's good. That's all right. I don't know about that's good for me. And then it says here, verse 5. By faith or through the channel of faith or using faith, Enoch was translated that he should not see death and was found not because God translated him. For before he translated, he had this testimony that he pleased God. But notice what it says, that through faith, he was translated that he should not see death. Do you know that if you are a believer that you won't see death? Hold on, Pastor. Now, you done gone a little bit too far now. Come on, I don't see nothing. You just said your grandmother would have got promotion. Yeah, but she didn't die. What y'all say? Who's he done lost his mind. Okay, let's go to 1 Thessalonians. Come on, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. We just gonna simply look at the scriptures. See, one thing about faith is what? We can't let what other people say about something be the determination of what it is. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 13. But I would not have you to be ignorant. There's a whole lot I can say with that. So the reason why God is sharing this with us is that he doesn't want us to be ignorant. Ignorant means not to know, right? But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren. So notice this is in love. Concerning them that are asleep. Someone who leaves their body who is a believer, God does not call them dead. He calls them merely asleep. Can you see that? In other words, what we should be saying is whatever he says. Okay, concerning them that are asleep, that you sorrow not at others that have no hope. So don't, yeah, you're going to grieve, but don't let it change your life and you can't move forward anymore. Why? Because they're just asleep. Verse 14. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them that which are those which asleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord. So in other words, God says this. So this is what we are to believe. Right? By the word of the Lord, that they which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. So in other words, those who have transitioned, those who are believers, they just simply moved. I'm not going to say they moved from Texas to California because that would be a demotion. But I'm just going to say they just simply moved. So if a person moved from here to Florida, guess what? You may feel sad that you're not going to see them every day, but your life is not going to be over because you're not going to see them every day. You know there's going to be a time where you're going to come together again, right? Well, it's the same way with those who have fallen asleep. You're going to see them again. In other words, guess what? God has just dealt with this major fear. It's what they call the fear of all fear, the fear of death. You don't have to fear death anymore because he just told you, you'll go to sleep, you won't die. Once you get over that, now you won't be restrained from doing anything that God wants you to do. Amen? All right, come on. I'm going to get to a couple things real quick. Okay. Now, he says, for he had this testimony that he pleased God. Well, how did he please God? Verse 6. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe. That's faith. That he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. I want to jump down specifically to something particular. I'm going to read verse 8 and come on down. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for inheritance, obeyed, and he went out not knowing whether he would go. By faith, or as a result of faith, or moved by faith, he sojourned into a land of promise. As a stranger in a country, dwell in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him unto the same promise. For he looked for a city which had foundations, whose builder and maker was God. Nieves, come here, please. Verse 11. Through faith, also Sarah herself received strength to receive seed and was delivered a child when she was past age, because what? She judged him what? Faithful, that promise. One moment. Now, a lot of people say, well, oh, the word was for back then. That was just them. I want you to share your testimony.
Pastor, that was actually one of the scriptures I was standing on during that time, was the one you just read.
Okay, go ahead.
In 2008, I got married to my husband, Josh, and we were at a different church, but we felt like we needed to be somewhere else, and my husband led us to this church. And so we came here, and we were in the church, and we were serving, and we were trying to have a child. But when I went to the doctor and got seen and checked, they said that was impossible, that you can't have any more children, you're beginning menopause, and it's not possible. And when I went to my car after I got that news, I was by myself, and I did a little bit of struggling and a couple of tears, but I was like, you know what? That's not what the Bible says. The Bible says that by his stripes I am healed. And that was one of the other scriptures I was standing on. And that's actually two places. It's in the New Testament and in the Old Testament. And then my husband was standing, and then I told my husband what the doctor had said. And he was like, you know what? We're going to believe for a child, and we're going to believe that God's going to bless us. And he stood on Exodus 23 and 25. And it says, and ye shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and thy water, and I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. There shall nothing cast their young, nor be barren in thy land. The number of thy days I will fulfill. And that was the scripture Josh was standing on. So we were both standing on the word of God. And I was serving on the ministry team, actually on the praise team. And we were in Dallas one time. And I was in the bathroom washing my hands, and Kate McVeigh was in there. And she told me, she goes, whatever you're believing for, that's going to come to pass.
Amen.
And I said, amen. And I was like, okay, that gave me confidence, and it was confirmation. And then another day, we were outside. It was at night, and Bishop, I was coming in, and then Bishop came around to the front, and I don't remember what he said exactly, but he prayed for me right there about being barren, and that God would heal me, and that we would have a child. And he prayed over me, and that's something he ministered to me. So that was a blessing that it put on our lives. And then we were flying again to Dallas to sing, and I felt sick. I was like, something's not right. I feel sick on a plane. And I had been on a plane before when I went to Michigan to visit the mother church. And I was like, something's not right with my body. So I went ahead and I took a pregnancy test, and I was pregnant. And that was in 2010.
How old is your boy, your son now?
And Joshua will be 12. Joshua Isaac, he'll be 12 in October.
Amen. Thank you. So what am I telling you? It doesn't matter what people say. It is what does God say, and what do you believe? That's just one thing there. I got another testimony I just want to share with you. Someone sent this in. Praise God. And it says, I want to share with you our praise report. Two Sundays ago, Pastor Bennett prayed with us concerning a situation where we needed God to intervene in providing help to pay for a $7,000 transmission on my husband's truck. Come on, think about that. All of a sudden, $7,000 come up. Okay. We stood on a verse where God shall supply all my needs according to his riches and glory. Not only did God provide, he exceeded our expectations and went further and paid off the truck, which was almost $20,000 in debts. In other words, it's debts demolished. Isn't that what we declare? Come on. Paid in full. We are grateful. We are grateful that we serve a good father. Our God is able and always on time. Hallelujah. But notice what happened in both those things. They both had a word that they believed, or in other words, they had faith, and they stood on it. And what happened? After you have done the will of God, you shall receive. Come on, isn't that just a word what we just read? So that's what we're talking about. We're talking about faith. And this is just a little bit. We have more testimonies to tell you what's going on here. Why? Don't let the enemy cause you to miss one session. Don't let the enemy, for whatever's going on, don't let him cause you to say, you know what, I feel like I want to lay in bed. You know, I don't feel good today. You know what, if they can bring that dead body in there, you can bring yourself in. Come on, let them heal you. We're talking about faith. Remember, you can't have life without faith. Come on. In order to accomplish what God has for you to do, it's going to take faith. In order for God to do you good all the days of your life, it's going to take what? So we're just introducing faith today. I just want to share with you a little bit of what's going on. Those who will believe God. Ooh, I'm not going to share that testimony. I wanted to share it right now, but I'm not going to share it. Come back next week, I'll share it with you. It'll bless your socks off. Come on, stand up with me. Anybody excited about faith?
Yes.
Come on. Think about how much God loves us, that he wants to get us straightened out on any areas that we may have let things slip. Any areas we might have got off a little bit. Any areas maybe we didn't know. He loves us. Father loves us so much and wants to do us good all the days of our lives
that he's bringing us back to the fundamental, foundational things. Why? So that we can go from faith to faith. From glory to glory. Do you know what limits God?
What? Yeah, what you say? Yes.
That which limits God is your faith. So what we're going to do, we're going to expand it. See, my grandfather had an old truck. I loved it. It was a Ford F-150. I loved it because it was his. You know, your granddad was his. He had a cab on the back. It was black with a cab on the back. And I was riding with him one day, and I noticed that the fuel needle was on E. And I'm like, are you going to get some gas? I was young, but I wasn't too young. I understood that we didn't have no gas. We weren't going anywhere, right? And what my grandfather did was he reached down and he flipped the switch. And all of a sudden, I saw that gas gauge go back up to full. I didn't know it, but it had two tanks. So what I'm trying to say, the Lord wants to extend us. To give us more range. That's what this faith series is about. He wants to give us more range. Come on. What you think is big is too little for him. He wants to expand it. What you think is good, he says it's not good enough. I want to expand it. Come on, God. Oh, man. He said, what you think is joy, I think it's not good enough. I want to expand it. Come on, God. He wants to expand you. And we're going to do it. He's going to do it. And we're going to grab hold. Anybody go decide by faith, you're going to grab hold of faith? Yeah. We're going to take it. We're going to seize it by faith. Come on, say, I'll take that. Come on, say that. I'll take that. Come on, reach up and by faith and take that. Come on, praise God. Amen. With every head bowed and every eye closed, no one moving, walking, or talking. I want to give you an opportunity, even now. One of the very reason that the Lord God gave us faith, one of the reasons is so that we can come back to him, that we can be born again. For he said this, if we would simply trust God with this one fact. It says in John 3:16 that God so loved the world that he gave his very best, his only begotten son, that whosoever shall believe in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. See, Jesus didn't come into the world to condemn the world because the world was already condemned. But he came that we may have life to the full so that it overflows. See, God wants you to come and make heaven. He wants heaven to be your home where you can live with him. Jesus told us what he did when he left. He says, I go to my Father and your Father. And he says, in my Father's house are many mansions. So think about this. He said, in my Father's house are many mansions. In other words, he's saying, I want you to live with me. I don't want you to live down the street, around the block, or someone else. I want you to live in my house with me. Not only that, but he wants to do life here on the earth with you. And it all starts by doing one simple thing. Trusting and believing what he said. That he loved you so much that he sent Jesus to die for your sins. That if you would believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, that he's the Son of God, that you shall be saved. So anyone here wants to make sure that heaven is their home? Anyone here would like to have God to do life with him? If that's you, whether you're online or here in the sanctuary, go ahead and lift up your hand even right now. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God, I see that hand. I see that hand. You may put them down. Well, perhaps you may say, well, Pastor Mario, I have accepted Jesus as my Lord and Savior. But I haven't been living how I know I should. The Word of God calls that being out of fellowship. But God loves us so much that he says this in 1 John 1:9. He said, if we will confess our sins, that he is faithful and just or trustworthy, we can believe him, that he will cleanse us from all unrighteousness, making us back right with him. If you would like to be restored back with good fellowship with him, and you want me to pray for you, just go ahead even right now and raise your hand in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Perhaps you may say, okay, one more thing. I said, one of the things that God does is when we come into the family of God, that he gives us a free gift. And that gift is the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the Bible evidence and speaking in other tongues. In other words, God has a private prayer language that he gives to you when you come into the family. And if you will want to receive that gift from the Father, then go ahead even right now and lift up your hands so that you can receive that gift. Amen. Glory to God. I see that. I see that hand. Amen. I see that. Amen. You may put them down. So what we're going to do, we're going to deal with that first invitation. And because we love you, we're going to pray along with you. Right, family? Yes. Don't we love them? Yes. Come on, we did this same thing. If you would simply mean this in your heart and make this faith confession, then you'll be saved. Say, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. That he died for my sins. They put him on the cross. They put him in a grave. But your word says that he is risen. He's alive right now. Say, dear Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Come into my life. And save me now. And I am right now born again. Heaven is my home. Jesus is my Lord. And God is my Father. Praise God. Well, I want to deal with that second invitation. Those who may have accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior, but again, they haven't been living how they know that they should. That word says if you would confess your sins. That word confess means simply acknowledge. In other words, what you have to say is, Father, I missed it. See, that's what sin means. Sin is actually an old archery term, which means to miss the target. So we missed the target that God had for us. He said, if you would simply say, Father, I missed it. He said that you can trust on him. He is trustworthy. He will cleanse you from all unrighteousness, making you back right with him. So you don't have to confess it to a man, but confess it to him. Now, I said that I would pray for you, so I'm going to do just that. And as I pray for you, you tell your Heavenly Father, because he's the only one who can do something about it, just tell him that you missed it and he'll do his part. You do your part, he'll do his part. You don't do your part, he can't do his part. Amen? Let's let him love on us. Go ahead, speak to your Father. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for everyone who is taking you at your word and confessing their sin unto you. I thank you, Father God, that you are trustworthy. We can count on you. You'll do exactly what you said. Even right now, you're removing the sin from them, and they stand before you right now, cleansed and whole in Jesus' name, with no condemnation. And they can come boldly before you, knowing that you will hear and answer their prayer in Jesus' name. Amen? Now, there is a third invitation. That invitation, we were talking about those who want to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the Bible evidence and speaking in other tongues. At the end of the service, I'm going to have ministers up front. And not only for them, but also someone who may have want someone to pray and believe God with them. Come up front. We'll have ministers up front who will share with you the word of God and who will pray with you concerning what the Bible says, knowing that God will hear and answer our prayer. How do you know that? Because I have faith in him and his word. So if you come up to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, you shall receive. I want to encourage you. Don't let the enemy talk you out of it. Don't let him cause you to run up out of here, but come forth. The Father wants to use you. Matter of fact, it says when you pray in the Spirit, it says that you exercise your most holy faith. That's why the enemy doesn't want you to do it. But come forth. Your Father loves you, and you shall receive in Jesus' name. Amen? Amen? Glory to God. Praise God. Come on, let's give God some glory and honor for his goodness. Anybody grateful for his word? Anybody grateful for this series that the Lord will have us to do? Oh, Lord, thank you for being so good and merciful. Oh, we love you. You're a good in every way. We have anything, Minister Ty? Well, praise God. Well, before you leave, I want you to find six people. Oh, what did you say, six people? Yeah, because I want you to see one another. Find six people and say, I have faith in God. God bless you. Have a wonderful evening. Amen.
Let's wake up the church with this old school.
jam. Shout to the Lord in here. You know that he's good and his mercy endures forever. And the people of God said, they said, what?